Hi all, and welcome to BMW channel. Guys, I have decided to create a couple easier to digest videos. What do I mean by that? Because a lot of my videos, I'm going like so deep into details, for example, with the ISTA, with the engineering software, or with the tool 32. It is even more engineering software. The programs are so complicated that if you are for the first time on my channel, you might think, whoa, it's some kind of rocket science. I don't understand anything about that. And that's why I'm just not deciding to join the channel. That's why for you guys, it will be a bit easier to digest video. What do I mean by that? In today's video, I'll cover a couple topics that are super useful if you're a beginner, and believe me, they will be still useful if you are professional as well. The difference will be, I will be discussing general fundamentals that you absolutely must know before you continue to code or program your BMW. Without knowing those basics, you'll be unable to make it correctly, and the most important, safely. So make a cup of tea or coffee, whatever you prefer, and enjoy following video. In today's video, I'll be talking about most common errors during programming of your BMW. Why I have decided to record a video about most common errors during programming of your BMW? Because actually, guys, I'm reading all the comments you're leaving under my YouTube videos, and I can actually feel what are your demands. If you feel that my videos do not cover all the aspects you're actually interested, feel free to write the comments with suggestions to the possible new videos. Before going to the actual topic of the video, I would like to express my gratitude to all the premium subscribers who has not only subscribed to the channel, but also clicked the join button and supporting my channel with some amount of cash. Thank you guys for that. And of course, as a premium subscriber, you are seeing that video way earlier than the rest of the YouTube. Why is programming so dangerous, and what could cause the errors during the programming? First of all, before going to exactly that topic, I need to explain a small difference between coding and programming. A lot of you don't understand the difference. Why is one procedure dangerous and another is safe? So the coding, actually, it is safe procedure. If you don't know anything about the coding, see my e-Sys for Dummies series. Over there, I'm explaining a lot of details. What is the coding? Basically, the coding is just changing the parameters inside the ECU that are already pre-programmed by the BMW engineers. So you are not adding anything new here, just playing with the parameters that are given to you. Of course, during the coding, you can add the parameters that were not were pre-designed and so on, but still, mainly you are just choosing between the parameters. And if during the coding procedure something goes wrong, the ECU itself, it actually remains active. It doesn't go bad, it's still communicating with you, and it's always possible to revert to the factory settings if you are dealing with the coding. That's why it is safe. But if you're talking about the programming, it is absolutely whole another story. Because during the programming, you can see what files are inside the ECU. We will be rewriting or updating at least one of those, or even the whole bunch of those different softwares inside the ECU. And if, for example, the bootloader will be corrupted, the ECU will be not responding at all, and you'll be unable to recover that. That's why programming as the procedure is way more complicated and way riskier. Because if something goes wrong, in the worst case, your ECU will be not responding or not working properly. You have to reprogram it again. Without that, it will just not work. And in the worst case, it will be not responding at all, and the only possibility will be recovering the ECU on the bench. Programming is writing a set of certain software inside the ECU. You cannot control anything about that. All the things you can do is make sure that all the things before the programming are set as they should be, and when the programming starts, you can just cross your fingers and wait. You cannot do anything better. You cannot make it faster. You cannot make it safer and so on. And if something goes wrong, that's it. So basically, before the programming, the only thing you can do is make sure all the preconditions are set. And only then you can proceed to the programming. So here is the list of errors that are most common why programming could fail. If you're preventing those, you're just increasing the probability of successful updating of the software of your BMW or a single ECU in the car. Mistake number one, actually not the mistake, but the reason number one why majority of the programmings fail is that power supply. Your BMW is made from different ECUs. You can see from picture over here. It is just a takeaway from the ISTA. You can see a lot of different boxes, green, yellow, red, and so on. Those are different ECUs. Basically, every ECU is a single computer. And of course, what does computer require to work? Of course, the power. You can see the different amount of ECU is just enormous. So the BMW consumes a lot of power to maintain all those ECUs in working order. And in order to program, you just have to have enough power. During the programming, the voltage should be around 14.3, 14.7 volts. In that period, in that range, it is the optimal. If the voltage drops below 12 volts during the programming, it will be aborted. Why? Because ECU, it just does not have enough power to stay working. That's why having good power supply before starting the update and actually during the update itself, it is just super important. What kind of the power supply I'm using, you can see in that video, ISTA for Dummies, I guess it was part 4, or there I'm describing actually in the details what type of the power supply I'm using. You don't have to use exactly the same one. The minimum requirements that are needed for BMW to be programmed is the power supply that is able to deliver up to 15 volts of power, and actually the most important is the amount of the amperes. It is required, basically, I recommend to use the power supplies that are between 70 and 100 amperes. Why such a range? Because BMWs are very sophisticated vehicles and they have a lot of ECUs. The more ECUs you have, the more power the BMW will consume. The same power supply will suit for BMWs, E, F, G series, I series, and so on. It doesn't matter. So if you just have the power supply between 70 and 100 amperes, it will be enough. I'm often asked, hey Vladimir, is that kind charger enough to update the software of my BMW? And the answer is no. As you can see over here, the regular battery charger or maintainer, its power output is only 5 to 10 amperes. It is not enough to supply with the power all the ECUs at the time. It is enough to recharge the car battery, but not to maintain the huge demands during the software update. Because during the software update, the consumption of the power sometimes can be as high as 70 or 80 amperes. And if your power supply cannot deliver enough power to all the ECUs, the power comes from the car battery. And if the car battery is being drained more than at a certain level, the programming will be aborted. So number one issue with programming abort is something is wrong with the power. Either the power supply was not strong enough, the car battery died if you did not use any power supply, and so on. So this is the most common error. Most common error number two is cable unplug. Because programming, it takes time. For example, programming of the head unit of BMWs, on average, it takes 45 to 50 minutes, sometimes a couple hours. And programming the whole vehicle where the head unit is included, it takes like 1-2 hours. It depends on the amount of ECUs and the type of the BMW you're working with. Of course, if you are going inside the car, you're putting the laptop on your knees, you're making all the preparations, and you start the updating the software, there is no point being in the car for the whole hour. Makes sense. So unplugging the cable is the reason number two. I had seen a lot of cases where the preparation is done properly. Everything, as I'm teaching on my channel, everything is prepared. You press program, you're sitting for 5 minutes, and then you feel okay. It's pointless to be here. I'll just go grab some coffee. You are putting the laptop really carefully, going out from the car, and then you just drag the cable either from the computer or from the USB, not USB, but from the car's OBD. And of course, if there is no communication, programming is being aborted. If you're fast enough and you are putting the cable back, sometimes you can be lucky and programming can still continue. But in majority of the cases, programming will be aborted. So be really careful with the cables. My suggestion would be, do not start the programming with the laptop on your knees. Go out from the car, set everything correctly, make sure all the connections are good, and only then press program, and then go enjoy your coffee. Case number three, that is most common, is laptop going to sleep. During the programming process, it cannot be interrupted, it cannot be paused, it cannot be hibernated, it just has to be done from the beginning until the end. That's why if your laptop goes to sleep, for example, your laptop was not configured properly in the power settings on the Windows. For example, after 20 minutes of inactivity, laptop goes to sleep. And of course, if laptop goes to sleep, it shuts down all the programs. And if you're using the ISTA or the e-Sys to program your BMW, of course, the process pauses. The car is still expecting, the car ECUs are still expecting some software to come in from the laptop, and nothing is happening. That's why the programming is being aborted. And believe me, it happens way more often than it should be happening. That's why before programming, make sure your laptop is configured properly. If the power supply is connected to the laptop as well, the laptop never goes to sleep. And if I'm programming from the laptop battery, I always configure so the laptop goes to sleep only after 3 hours of inactivity. Why 3 hours? Because I'm not just leaving the laptop to program the BMW, I'm always monitoring the situation. So every 5-10 minutes, I come closer to the laptop and see how the process is going on. Because if something went bad, I'm just wasting time because the programming was aborted. So be really careful with that. Configure your laptops properly. And because we're already talking about the laptops, it is just the basic issue with the Windows laptops. If you're going to program, always connect power supply to your laptop. One thing is going to sleep. Second thing is your laptop battery dies. And actually the third thing, when the power supply is connected to your Windows laptop, Windows, it works differently based on the power delivery. It can use way more resources, and sometimes the programming can go faster when the power supply is connected compared to that when you are just running from the battery. Of course, it might be different based on different laptops, but on average, if you connect the power supply to a laptop, it will never harm. It's always good. And fourth reason is using third-party multi-tools to program BMWs. I'm not telling third-party multi-tools absolutely useless. No, they're not. Sometimes they have even better diagnostic options for making the diagnostics of the BMWs than, for example, the original ISTA. But do not use any third-party multi-tools to work with different brands to update the software of your BMW. Why? Because very often, if you're updating your BMW not with the ISTA or with the e-Sys, but with third-party multi-tool, sometimes it updates the car well, but very often the update just fails because the tools that are designed to work with all the cars in the world just cannot handle as sophisticated cars as BMWs. Very often update fails due to very many reasons. That's why just don't do it. Stick only to the original tools to program the BMWs. If you would like to, you can use still third-party multi-tools to diagnose the vehicle, the BMWs, but not to program those. Believe me, it is the case number four why the programming could go wrong. And that's it. In today's video, we have discussed four most common reasons why the programming of your BMW can go wrong. Number one was issues with the power supply, either the power supply to the whole vehicle or the power supply, for example, to your laptop, just the battery dies. Number two was unplugging the cable. Unfortunately, yes, it happens way often that you might think. Number three was laptop going to sleep. And number four, using non-original tools to program the BMWs, like third-party multiscanners. If you have any ideas about the similar topics that should be discussed on my channel that has not been discussed yet, absolutely feel free to write your comments with your suggestions, and maybe next video will be done based on your suggestion. Thank you all, and see you next time. Bye.